And welcome to KBLP with yours truly, Denise Harris, and the Hollywood Review, where we talk gossip, movies, and music. So, let's get right into it. There's a lot of movies that open this week. Let's get to the box office reviews for the past week. And again, number one, we have Kingsman, The Golden Circle. It's supposed to be really excellent. So I suggest you go see it. If you haven't seen the first one either, go see it. Excellent movie. Number two, again this week, It. Rotten Tomatoes gives it an 85%. I highly recommend it. There's some changes, yeah, but I think it's well worth a see. The guy who played Richie, a fabulous kid, fabulous. And of course, Pennywise is creepy as all get out, so... So I highly recommend go seeing that movie. If you haven't seen it, please go see it. Number three this week is American Made. Rotten Tomatoes gives it an 87%. And that is number three that opened this week. The critics really enjoyed it. American Made's fast and loose attitude with its real-life story mirrors the cavalier and delightfully watchable energy Tom Cruise gives a leading role. So there you go. Are you a Tom Cruise fan? I don't know. It depends. And this pilot is recruited by the CIA to provide reconnaissance on the communist threat in Central America. Finds himself in charge of one of the biggest covert CIA operations in the history of the U.S. So if you're into that, that is the movie to see. So American Made with Tom Cruise. Number four this week, the Lego Ninjago movie. Okay, not one of my favorites, but if you like Legos, that's the movie to go see. Number five this week, Flatliners, which opened today. Again, remakes, reboots. And the critics say Flatliners falls flat as a horror movie and fails to improve upon its source material. And they say this reboot is dead on arrival. Uh-oh. And, of course, you know what Flatliners is about. It's about the medical students hoping to get an insight into the mystery of what lies beyond the confines of life. And they embark on a daring and dangerous experiment. And each triggers a near-death experience. And the investigation becomes more and more perilous, and they are forced to confront the sins of their past. So I don't know if you really like the original. I don't know if you want to go see the remake. Unfortunately, there's more remakes coming. They're on the board. So, sad but true. Number six this week is Battle of the Sexes. And Rotten Tomatoes actually gives us 84%. It's a crowd-pleasing, well-acted dramedy. Entertains well, summing up present-day parallels. And, of course, you know... This is the sexual revolution and the rise of women's movement between Billie Jean King and Bobby Riggs, Steve Carell. And Billie Jean King is played by Emma Stone. So for anybody who doesn't know about that, maybe you should see it. I don't know. But it is given a 84% by Rotten Tomatoes, so... maybe something you might want to see at home when it comes out on DVD. Number seven this week, American Assassin. It was number four last week. Unfortunately, Rotten Tomatoes only gives it a 33%. And the critics say has a few easy targets, but without enough style or wit to bring its characters to life or stand out in a field of more compelling spy thrillers. So, I don't know. It follows the rise of Mitch Rapp, who's played by Dylan O'Brien, a CIA black ops recruit under the instruction of Cold War veteran Stan Hurley, played by Michael Keaton. They are enlisted by the CIA to investigate a wave of apparently random attacks. So again, another CIA spy movie. So again, maybe something you wait for DVD and watch it at home. Number 8 this week, which was number 6 last week, is Home Again. And Rotten Tomatoes only gives this a 30%. So, and the critics, it gathers a talented crowd of rom-com veterans on both sides of the camera, all of whom have done better work. Uh-oh, not good. It's stars Reese Witherspoon as Alice Kinney in a modern romantic comedy. Michael Sheen, who is her estranged husband, and she decides to go back to her hometown with her two young daughters. So, you know, it looks good. Cute, anyway. I don't know. But like I said, Rotten Tomatoes only gives it 30%. You might like it. I don't know. Number 9 this week came out today, Till Death Do Us Part. No, nothing on it yet. Critic comments or anything yet. Michael and Madison Rowland had planned to spend the rest of their lives together until one day Michael's controlling reins turned their perfect marriage into an abusive roller coaster no woman could survive. With the help of her best friend, Madison decides to get away. So, could be good. I don't know. We might have to wait and see what they say about that. That opened today. Number 10 this week is Mother. It was 5 last week. Actually, Rotten Tomatoes gives it a 67%. So, the critics say there's no denying that Mother is a thought-provoking product of a singularly ambitious artistic vision, although it may be too unwieldy for mainstream tastes. And this movie is about a couple's relationship as tested when uninvited guests arrive at their home, disrupting their tranquil existence. Jennifer Lawrence, Javier Bardem, Ed Harris, and Michelle Pfeiffer. I would see it just for the cast. It looks pretty good. And it looks like a cross between The Strangers and Rosemary's Baby. So, interesting. So, those are the top 10 box offices this week. Also, The Snowman's supposed to have started today, I believe. That looked rather interesting. It really did. That looked pretty good. A cop investigated an ominous snowman and fears a serial killer is active again. It's a deadly... He only strikes in the wintertime, and it's a deadly game of cat and mouse as a murderer deliberately taunts and torments, and I lied. It opens on the 20th. I am sorry. I thought it opened today, but it did not. That opens on the 20th, but that really looked good. I hope I'm coming through. I don't know. And I did play our song for the week that you have to guess what it's from. Love Train by Tommy Lee. What movie is that from? I'll play it a couple times. And then I'm going to play about half of the song from last week and give you the answer to that. Okay, today, Blade Runner opened. Blade Runner 2049. That looked really, really good with Ryan Gosling and Harrison Ford. That looked really, really good. Rotten Tomatoes gives it an 89%. So that's pretty good. I think I'd go to see this with Harrison Ford in it. And, of course, Ryan Gosling. How can you not? So, that looked really good, actually, I think. The critics even, the consensus on it's visually stunning and narratively satisfying. Blade Runner 2049 deepens and expands its predecessor story while standing as an impressive filmmaking achievement in its own right. 30 years after the first film, a new Blade Runner, LAPD Officer K, played by Ryan Gosling, unearths a long-buried secret that has the potential to plunge what's left of society into chaos. K's discovery leads him on a quest to find Rick Deckard, who's played by Harrison Ford, a former LAPD Blade Runner. It just looks really good. Robin Wright's in it, Mackenzie Davis, and of course Harrison Ford and Ryan Gosling. Yay! Excellent, excellent. So that might be one to see. Mountain Between Us opened today with Idris Elba and Kate Winslet. I unfortunately, Rotten Tomatoes only gives it 46%, but I think it looks really, really good. Maybe too far-fetched, but it's elevated by engaging performances from both actors. They're stranded after a plane crash. Two strangers must forge a connection to survive the extreme elements of a remote snow-covered mountain. When they realize help is not coming, they embark on a perilous journey across hundreds of miles of wilderness. That looked really good. Idris Elba, Kate Winslet, Beau Bridges, Dermot Mulroney is also in it. So that looked really well. That looked really good. I would recommend go seeing that. And a kind of a funny side note, what Kate Winslet had to say. She let out a secret of Idris Elba's. Kate Winslet let out of the bag that Idris Elba, and get this, Lori, get this, Idris Elba has a foot fetish. He requested Kate Winslet wear socks during the filming, not because she had ugly feet, but he had a foot fetish. So there you go, some inside info on that. My Little Pony, the movie, came out today. And of course, you know, I have to take Dakota sometime soon. So I'll let you know how that one goes. Victoria and Abdul opened today. That is with Judi Dench. Of course, you know her from James Bond fame. It reunites Judi Dench with the role of Queen Victoria, which is all this drama needs to overcome its imbalanced narrative. It's a true story of unexpected friendship in the later years of Queen Victoria's remarkable rule. When Abdul Karim Ali Fazal, a young clerk, travels from India